the vinegar room.
Okay.
So a vinegar room, it looks like, that knows what a vinegar room is.
You
know what a vinegar room is? You want to touch it? I don't have my phone.
Is it
tricky? Vinegar room looks like a scorpion, but it doesn't have
what?
Have she ever been out of this room?
Yeah, we take her over there all the time. We'll take her outside. If we have a big group like yesterday, we'll do a show outside. We did it over there in another building yesterday. And whenever she gets ready to shed, we take her over there and we literally let her soak in the bathtub.
Yeah, I was going to ask about that.
His tail looks fake.
He's a big boy. He's chunky. he's a big boy. Absolutely. The new one has to just be super careful. He'll probably try to wrap around you and get in that spot with you.
Wesley?
Come here, Mama.
Okay, there you go. There's your picture. Put him back.
She's perfectly fine.
Yep.
Do you want to hold her back, please?
Python down there. They are easy. Not easy. They're common to find in captivity, but they're endangered in the wild.
Oh. Okay.
Are you coming in
okay.
or not?
Yeah, I've never even heard of them.
Alright, look.
Girl, I'm here just to be your friend.
If it makes you feel any better, snakes don't have the part of their brain to feel emotion, so they don't not like you. Or like you, either way. They see you as, can I eat it? Is it going to eat? They have labial pits right there. That's where they do their meat sensing.
Okay. And they smell with their tongue, right?
They're not really up to people, though, right?
Yeah. They don't gain anything from biting you. That puts them more at risk than anything.
Guys, I gotta do this. Okay.
They can't harm you in any way.
Yeah,
it's not a harm.
I know.
I think it's. I don't know how
you need to start facing your fears, because you got a lot of fears. And this is her biggest one. So if she gets over this fear, like, you can get over it.
This girl that he's got right here, this is one of my snakes. She's a baby.
She's a baby, my goodness.
I am scared. Is that the anaconda?
No, she's a boa.
Okay, boa. We have this in Puerto Rico.
She's a baby.
Because she was in the corner. So I reached over there, and I guess she just saw me dangling it, and she was, goodness. My head went all the side.
Ellen, you want to hold it?
But then she realized water was coming out. And she was
you
like,
want to catch him? No, okay, you don't have to. I was not a fan. But I promised my nephew. He was like,
all of the animals here is a huge part of this, also. Because, again, like with this guy, y'all saw him hiss when we took him out. Mm-hmm. He's fairly new. We've had him 3 weeks now, maybe. And it's just with as big as he's going to be, he'll be the third largest snake in the world. And that's way too big of a snake to have not friendly.
Right.
So we have to spend time with all of these guys. The babies. All the animals over there that we just got
around Africa, so pretty much he just likes it nice and hot and dry. When he's full grown, he'll be about 5 feet long, so he's still pretty young, so he's got a long way to go.
He's just having a blast.
And then hiding in here is our new rescue. This is Bert. Bert is a Schneider's dwarf caiman, so he is part of the crocodilian family. So he will max out at about 5 feet long. We rescued him because the person who had him had rehomed him 3 times.
That's big boy over there. One of the differences between alligators and crocodiles and caimans is that alligators and crocodiles have these cone-shaped teeth. They have these sharp little daggers.
Oh, okay.
And
yeah,
those are
the
little tiny.
He's pretty neat. He's going to be a work in progress for a while, though. He's obviously, he's never going to be one that gets to be able to be passed around like most of ours, but they're not very big bodied. They're actually taller than most snakes and kind of skinnier
at
the bottom. So they live in the deserts, and they've evolved to where they keep as little of their body on the ground as possible because it's so hot.
Yeah.
So that's why at the bottom, you've got this much touching the ground, but then they're taller.
Slender. Mm-hmm.
So kind of a neat adaptation there.
Well,
I think the corn snake is the prettiest one.
She's the best one.
Terrifying.
She is.
Oh, it's the prettiest though.